Now that we've created our body of influence, we are going to split our wing face into three faces. So, back to the ZX plane, select the Y axis, and let's zoom in again. So, very simply, click ZX, and New Sketch. In the Sketching tab, simply select Line. Now, we'll create one line, extend all the way to the next part of the body of influence sketch, and create another line. Now we're going to add some constraints. We want these lines to be parallel with the leading and the trailing edge, respectively. So, since this line is parallel to the leading edge, we want this line and this line to be parallel. It's the same with these two lines, so we want this line and this line to be parallel. Now, we're going to add some dimensions. So, we want the distance between this axis and this point, it's very tiny here, but we want the distance to be 0.1 feet. Next, we want the distance between this point and this point to be 0.75 feet. There. Now, if we go back into modeling, we're going to go to Concept and Lines from Sketches. It's Sketch 3, so Apply, and then click Generate. Finally, to split our face, we're going to go into Tools. We're going to go to Projection. Our edges, you have to hold down the Control button to select both, will be the ones that we just created. And the target is going to be the top face of our wing. It's easy if you change the orientation and zoom in. And for the target, it will be the top face. So you have a lot of faces to choose from. Make sure that you're selecting the top face. And apply. The direction vector is going to be the plus y direction. So, here's our y-axis. And let's zoom out. And that's the wrong direction. This is the right direction. And now, we have to click Generate. So now we're almost finished with the geometry. Let's just go here, and we're going to suppress our line bodies. So right click, suppress body, and then finally, for our flow domain body, change it from solid to fluid. And now we're done.